हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ मेड फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर फॉर क्लास BA पार्ट 3. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द पोएम डोंट कॉल मी इंडो एंग्लियन एंड दिस पोएम वॉज कम्पोज बाय सैयद अमानुद्दीन. सैयद अमानुद्दीन वॉज बॉर्न इन 1934, इज़ अ US बेस्ड इंडियन पोइट who writes in the modernist American tradition on a wide range of topics from love to science. Indian writing in English is a body of work by writers in India who write in the English language and whose native or native language could be one of the numerous language of India. As the poem name suggests, there is a keyword Indo-Anglian. It is frequently referred to as Indo-Anglian literature. Indo-Anglian is a specific term in the sole context of writing that should not be confused with Anglo-Indian. So basically, Indo-Anglian writing is the writing in which the writer is from India, whose native or native language could be one of the numerous language of India, but who write in English language. So Sayyed Amanuddin is one of them writers. And if we talk about the poem, this poem is part of the ever ongoing discussion on whether an Indian should write in English when he or she has the wealth of his or her own mother tongue available. Other poems in this genre include Kamala Das's An Introduction and Nisim Ezekiel's Background Casually, among others. This issue was addressed by Mahesh Dattani, the playwright, who, when asked why he did not write in his own language instead of in English, retorted that was what he did. And dear students, on your screen you can see the summary of this poem Don't Call Me Indo-Anglian by Sayyed Amanuddin. Sayyed Amanuddin was born and brought up in Mysore, South India, and later he migrated to America. This is the reason that his poetry unifies the Indian clarity and American modernity. Sayyed Amanuddin is a poet with a blend of Indian essence and American flavor in his writing. His works capture the essence of the human experience, like joy, happiness, love, pain, suffering and death. He has a very distinguished style of writing which resembles to E.E. Cummings' style of writing. Both of them introduce the avant-garde style in writing poetry, which experiments the conventional rules of syntax and punctuation. His poem Don't Call Me Indo-Anglian is the best example, which unfolds, means which shows, which reveals the liberty to use his syntactic structure, his uses of negative words like hop, hodgepodge, confusion, nullity, abortive, unveil his disgust as he was put in the category of Indo-Anglian man of letters. So now if we start the poem start with the opening lines like, "No, I don't want to be a hodgepodge of culture." And dear students, if you will notice the text, you will notice that the lines of this poem start with the small letters, and the literal meaning of the vocabulary is conveyed throughout the poem. No, I don't want to be a hodgepodge of culture. Now in these lines, the poet rejecting his desire to be a blend or to be a confused mixture of different culture. He doesn't want to be a mixture of culture. अ कन्फ्यूजन ऑफ लैंग्वेज, अ नलिटी ऑफ इमेजिनेशन मीन्स अ लैक ऑफ इमेजिनेशन, एन अबॉर्टिव अफेयर बिटवीन एन एन इंडो एंड एन एंग्लो. अबॉर्टिव अफेयर मीन्स insignificant, immature or useless, or we can say futility of imagination. So he doesn't want to be a mixture of culture, he doesn't want to be a confusion of language, he doesn't want to be insignificance or lack of imagination, and also he doesn't want to be useless affair between an Indo and an Anglo. Next he says that I hate hyphens. Hyphen means the sign which is used to join words to indicate that they have a combined meaning. Dear students, if you have ever noticed about compound noun, then you can easily recognize what is hyphen. This sign is used to show the meaning of a combined word, and it can also show that they are linked in the grammar of a sentence. So he is saying that I hate hyphens. Hyphens here, according to the poet, hyphen here refer to the artificial bridges that is made between these two culture, that is Indian and American. So he is saying that I hate hyphens, the artificial bridges between artificial values in the name of race, religion and language. So in this pair of lines he is showing his disgust towards becoming a hyphen and behaving like a hyphen that is used to show the combined meaning of two cultures, two religions, two languages or two races. Next he is saying that I damn all hyphenated minds. Now he again directly attacking the people who have a narrow minded thinking, and he is saying that I protest those hyphenated minds prejudiced offsprings of unenlightened souls. Now notice the phrase, the poet is comparing those hyphenated minds with prejudiced issues of unenlightened means uneducated souls. Next he's saying that I denounce all labels and label makers. Denounce means hate or damning. He is damning all labels and label makers. I refuse to be a moonrock specimen. Now he is moonrock specimen means sample. Now he is saying that I don't want to be a sample. I don't want to be a reference to Indo-Anglian literature. So he is saying that I refuse to be a moon rock specimen to be analyzed, labeled and stored. He doesn't want to be analyzed, he doesn't want to be labeled, and he doesn't want to be stored for a curious gloomy fellow to reanalyze, reclassify me for shelving me again. Shelving here means to put in a complete box of thinking. So he is saying that I don't want to be a sample, to be stored, to be labeled, to be analyzed, and I don't want to be a material for some gloomy fellow, for some indifferent fellow, for some melancholic fellow to reanalyze me, to reclassify me for his shelf, for the sample of his self. They call me Indo-Anglian, I don't know what they mean. Now he is trying to find the meaning of Indo-Anglian particularly. And in the next line, he is showing his interest toward Indian culture and his despise toward the hyphenated minds, toward the unenlightened souls who are categorizing the poets in Indo-Anglian or Anglo-Indian and the same. In the next line, he is saying, the Kaveri flows in my veins. Here he is giving us the reference of Kaveri River that flow through the states of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, and its origin is from western Ghat of India. So he is saying that Kaveri flows in my veins, Chamundi Hills rise in my mind with stars afloat. Chamundi Hills is situated in Mysore, and basically Sayyed Amanuddin is from South India. So he is saying that Kaveri flows in my veins and Chamundi Hills rise in my mind with the stars afloat, eyes of the goddess smiling on the slain demon. Here he is mentioning the incarnation of goddess Durga, and he is saying that I have the impact of Hindu mythology, where is goddess Durga smiles after slaying a demon. Vrindavan fountains sing in my soul their musical colors. And now in the last line of this stanza, he is mentioning the love culture of Hindu mythology, of Indian mythology, and he doesn't want to be separated from this culture, and that's why he hate to be called Indo-Anglian. So that is the theme of this poem, and in this poem, this ever ongoing discussion is celebrated in this poem. In the next video, we will discuss the remaining part of the poem. So that's all for today, students. Thank you all.